I'm Thomas. You might know me from Thomas the Tank Engine and Friends or the ever-popular PBS show, Shining Time Station. I'm here to inform you about the changes to America by the appearance of the railroads, and who better to inform you than myself, a steam engine.
How about an engineer?
Who said that?
Or conductor? Or I bet even one of those flashing railroad crossing signs know more than you do.
Where are you?
Over here. I'm John Tucker, and I've been rooting around here about 100 years now. I've been meaning to talk to one of your kinds.
Well, that'll have to wait. I have to tell these students about the improvements of our nation by the use of our railroads. So if you could, please hold all comments to the end of my presentation. To continue on...
Who put something up his caboose?
I'm sure that was the crew, but anyway... Railroads helped fuel the growth in American business, but it wasn't until the 1840s and 50s that there was a boom in the building of railroads. As you can see here, in the 1830s there were only 23 miles of track. By 1840, over 2,800 miles were laid, and then by 1850 there were more than 9,000 miles. The growth within the decade leading up to 1860 was distinguished by the connection of many smaller tracks to other smaller tracks to create long routes. By 1860, there were 30,000 miles of laid track.
I got long roots. I've been growing them for over a century now, the old-fashioned way. I swear my roots are 20 times stronger than any roots them meatbags came up with.
I think you're talking about some other kind of root. Please don't interrupt. As I was saying...
Maybe you should go let off a little steam.
Right. Well, the presence of railways all over the East allowed the connection of regions, which allowed companies to ship goods long distances that were not connected by rivers. Even people began to take trains, which could carry up to 60 passengers. Trains also included cars for specific purposes. These cars included those such as boxcars, freight cars, cattle cars, and lumber cars. Eventually, railroads became the preferred means for transportation over canals and turnpikes. The reason for the railroad's success was because it allowed for more direct interaction than other modes. Railroads were also cheaper to make through uneven land than digging canals, and were cheaper to keep up for every ton mile than canals. They were also faster. Trains allowed people to travel faster than a horse, which had never happened before. Here's a map of the time it took for travelers getting from New York City to other parts of the country in 1800 compared to the time it took in 1830 with the appearance of the railroads. In 1800, it took a week to get from New York City to North Carolina. By 1830, this trip only took 2 to 3 days. In 1800, it could take 5 weeks to get to Mississippi. By 1830, it only took 2 weeks. And finally, by 1860, it only took 4 weeks to get to California. This was a dramatic change in transportation for Americans at that time. It could be compared to the possibility of getting somewhere up far north in only an hour as compared to 8 or more hours. The availability of rapid transportation allowed businesses to depend on other regions to bring them goods they needed for their services. An example of this could be the need of southern cotton by northern textiles.
Boring.
Okay, how about you take over then?
Okay, now how about a joke? Why is a railroad always angry? People are always crossing it.
Wow.
Well, how about another? Why can't an engineer be electrocuted? Because he's not a conductor.
Okay, this was a bad idea. How about...
Wait, I got one more. What do trains call cutting down trees and tearing up the land?
I don't know, what?
Progress.